gatherings. For some of us, Christmas is long, long ago. For some of us, maybe it was last year or even this year, something that has touched you deeply. Maybe it wasn't particularly funny, but touching, and it moved you. A gift that someone gave to you, someone thinking of you. Maybe it was a picture one of those kids we laughed about had drawn for you as a gift. It could have been so many things, things we remember. And then there are those things that we all remember and are deeply touched by. Can any of us forget some of the faces and families in Newtown, Connecticut tonight? Can you forget the way you looked at your own children or grandchildren or nieces or nephews and maybe hugged them and told them that you loved them after hearing those stories? You see, those are the things that we remember for a long time, and they're often beyond words. They move us and touch us deeply. We don't have words to get that deep. But I'd like to think that there's even a deeper place. Not that God's Spirit doesn't help us with the lists of this and that that we so easily forget and move from one to another. Not that God is in the midst of those things that move us deeply. But I'd like to think that what Mary experienced was something beyond anything she had a hand in. She treasured and pondered who this Jesus was and what he was about. That's the work of the Spirit. And I think it's there for all of us. If we'll but pause and treasure and ponder. That's the way Christmas lasts. The poet said that the world does not require so much to be informed as to be reminded. And that's why we do what we do. That's why we gather here. Unlikely that we'll hear anything new that we haven't heard before in the Christmas story. But maybe we'll experience something new as we remember. And Christmas is about remembering. It's not a list. It's even deeper than the things that just touch us and move us. But like Mary, it's about treasuring. It's about pondering. See, even on that first Christmas, there were many things to be remembered. Crowded inns, a stable, census, politics of the day, soldiers marching in and out, a busy street, camels, animals, people scrambling, all sorts of things that worked their way into the memories of shepherds and wise men. Fathers and mothers, Mary and Joseph. But Mary chose to treasure and ponder. She remembered in a way that was the work of the Spirit. And that's what I invite you to do tonight. I hope that you've completed all of your lists and you have remembered all of those things that you're supposed to remember tonight. I hope that you will remember all beautiful moments, the funny moments, the entertaining moments of family gatherings, friends, all that you do tonight and tomorrow. But I also hope that you'll take a cue from Mary herself, who treasured and pondered all that she had heard, all that she had experienced, so that in times to come, she remembered not just a list, not just great thoughts about a time in the past, but an openness to the Spirit to treasure and ponder a Savior who brings love and peace and joy and forgiveness and wholeness and healing. Treasure and ponder is to remember the level of faith, the place of the Spirit. May we too remember the Christmas story tonight, treasuring